Psalms 119 verses 145 to 152. As we do koph or koph. You ever try to apply for a job and they ask for experience only? Well, now we're getting into experience from the word. I cried with my whole heart. It's not half-heartedness you give to God. It's giving God your whole heart. What would be a half heart? Oh, I go to God and then I go to the doctor. Oh, yeah, I go to God, but I go to the bank. That's a half heart. Is there nothing wrong going to the doctor? No, Jesus said those are sick and they need a physician. But you need to go to God first. And then see what God tells you to do. He may tell you to go to a doctor. He may tell you to go to a fellow Christian and get money. I don't know. But a whole heart is going to God first. Hear me. He's talking to God. He's saying, God, come to you with a full heart. Hear me. O Lord, I will keep thy statutes. And I don't think that's a condition, Lord, hear me and I'll keep your statutes. Lord, you know, I got this prayer. I'm coming to you. Listen, Lord, I'm going to keep your statutes. Or under the Old Testament, it's based upon works. I cried unto thee, God, I cried unto thee, save me. That's almost what Peter said. Lord, can I step out and walk on the water? Yeah, come. And the storms come, he takes his eyes off Jesus and he cries out, save me. Those are the two words there that every man needs that is born of a woman. He needs to cry unto God and say, save me. And I shall keep thy testimonies. What's the testimony? I'll give you a testimony. For 18 years as a miserable sinner, knelt down at 773 Broad Street Extension in Waterford, Connecticut. As Joe Caswell opened up the Bible, Joe Whitmore witnessing the event, I trusted the Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior on a Saturday afternoon. He saved a miserable, wretched sinner as me. That's the testimony of me saying, Lord, save me. And there is a video and an audio of my testimony, not completely full, but a testimony of what the Lord has done for me. And the Lord has done too much for me that I don't even deserve. And if you've cried unto the Lord to save me, you've got a testimony. And everyone's save me testimony is different. Don't you listen to a pastor give a testimony and think, well, if it didn't happen to me like that, no. We're only telling you what God has done in our lives, and what God has done in our lives is not specific what God is going to do or has done in your life. I was saved kneeling at a coffee table. There are people saved in a camp meeting. There are people saved in a hospital bed. There are people saved on a boat, in a car, in a regular church. Who knows Maybe in a prison. I witnessed two men that got saved in a prison. What? Because I didn't get saved in a prison? No, see? It is your testimony of God's testimony. It says thy testimony. God has done something in your life, and it will not be like someone else. In verse 145, I cried out of my own heart, O Lord, hear me. I cry unto thee, save me. You got to call upon God. Now, there's a lot of things I've read about this. I prevented the dawning of morning. And I took a more reliable source of the books and things I've read and all-night prayer meeting with the Lord. And cried. These three verses are prayer to God, and so much that it's overnight. Few say that he woke up before dawn, before morning, to pray. I guess either or. I hoped in thy word. So let me ask you, what does Bible say about prayer? Do you know? Do you know at least three verses about prayer? Because he says, I hope in thy word, and we're talking about prayer. My eyes prevent the night watches, that I might meditate in thy word. All night long he's in the word. He's thinking about the word. He's meditating on the word in the night. He can't sleep. Or he doesn't want to sleep. He may be fasting sleep to get an answer to prayer. Some people, if they can't sleep, they get up and they watch television. Never even thinking about opening their Bible at that time. Hear my voice according unto thy loving kindness. Lord, you love me. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Lord, if you really love me, I need help. O Lord, quicken me means to be made alive according to thy judgment. They draw nigh that follow after mischief. These are people who are against the Bible. They are far from thy law. They don't do what God tells them to do. So the prayer is that this guy, he's getting attacked by people who do not follow God. There are people out there who will not say they're going to kill you. They will kill you if they're given the opportunity, because you are who you are in the Lord. Thou art near, O Lord, and all thy commandments are truth. The Lord is near unto you. You better not be in sin. You better be confessed up on your sins and sorry for your sins, because you may get a time in your life where you're in all night prayer meeting and you're getting the word to find out what the trouble is. And if you are in your sin, how near is the Lord to you? The commandments are truth. You know, that what they say is the Lord's Prayer, which is the disciples' prayer. It says right there, you know, the trespasses. How can God forgive us our trespasses? We don't forgive those who trespass against us. One of the commandments for the born-again Christian is to love the brethren. Well, if you don't love the brethren, you're not going to get the answer to prayer. Because love is God, and if you love the brethren, you are in the Lord. You're not in the flesh if you love others. Thou art near, O Lord, and all thy commandments are true. Concerning thy testimonies, I have known of old, and this is the experience, that thou hast founded them forever. In a serious time of prayer, and you will be in those times, when the enemy is after you, and you're pleading to God to answer, and you're pleading to God to save you, you are even reading your Bible. You are praying at night. And this trouble may be even keeping you awake. And still in 49, you're crying out to God to hear you. God, he's not hearing you. Well, he hears you. You don't think he's hearing you. And the enemy approaches in 150, he's getting closer and closer. While God is near. Samson was a chosen vessel before his birth. He was anointed by God. And one of those particular things assigned for Jews, his hair. Samson kept messing around. And God just stood back and like, okay. When you want to do right, we'll work together and do right. When you want to fool around your sin, I'm going to step back. And when Samson wanted to do right, there was victory. God's victory over the enemies, the Philistines. And then Israel comes up to him and says, well, you know, you're making him upset and all that. We're going to bind you. And he went off sinning. And then he got involved with that woman there. And I can't think of her. Delilah. And messed around. And God stepped back. There was no prayer. There was game playing. At the end of his life, here he is chained. Here he is probably naked. They put this little child up next to him. Hey, here's this big warrior, and here's this little child holding him by, you know, like a dog. And sorry for his sins and repenting of his sins, he calls upon God in prayer. And God answers and gets a victory. And he's listed in the Heroes of Faith. He learned this experience too late in life. And what you've got to learn from an experience of prayer is prayer does work when you do right. God does hear. And God will answer yes, no, not now. But because your prayer has not been answered to you, to your liking, doesn't mean you don't stop the prayer. You don't stop the Bible study. And you may even have to fast your time or something. And the enemy's coming. Yet God is near. I'll never leave thee or forsake thee. If you are a born-again Christian, God will never leave you, no matter what gross sin you have. But that fellowship between you two. You might even die as a Christian in your sin. The wages of sin is death, is written to a Christian in Romans 6. And you get to heaven, you're standing before the Lord Jesus Christ, and I don't know, Lord, why didn't you answer that prayer? Why am I here today now with you? Because you wouldn't listen. You indulge in your sin. Experience will tell you through Genesis to Revelation. You need to be a clean vessel. You need to be in the Word. You need to be in prayer. You need to be thinking of others. You need to give of yourself cheerfully. And again, Psalms 119 is the longest chapter in the whole Bible, and it's about the Word. It's all about the Word. And you are to have hope in the Word of what God says. And you are to meditate in what the Word says. The Bible says you are to study. You can't go run for a passage that's applied to Jews and claim it. You better make sure what you're proclaiming before God is the Word, and what you're proclaiming in your meditation is better be for you. Again, if you deny not the Lord, the Lord's not going to deny you. That you can use that. Say, Lord, I feel been denied by you, and I haven't denied your name. I haven't denied you. Concerning thy testimonies, what God has done. I have known of old that thou hast founded them forever. Thy words are settled in heaven forever. Only these words that are before you are the words you're going to read in heaven. You're not going to read novels and that other junk. Only the Word of God will be where we're going. Only lost souls that you help turn to Jesus Christ will be waiting for you. And that's it. That's the only two things you're going to carry over into heaven. So, when you get to heaven and experience only. Well, I got experience. What experience do you got? Lay them down at the judgment seat of Christ. And what experience you have will be gold, silver, and precious stones. How about that? All according to the Word. What must I need to do to get the gold? Read the Word. What must I do to get the silver? Read the book. What is wood, hay, or stubble? Study the book. Precious. How do I win the soul? read the book. Don't go buy a book at a Christian and all that other junk bookstores. Read the book. Get experience. The more you finish reading your Bible, the more study you do the Bible, the more experience you get. And if you keep yourself clean, God will use you in particularities of your life that no one else will be able to do. Experience comes by the book. How often are you in it? How often do you study it? Study brings experience.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art.
And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing he bled and died to take away my sin.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great.
When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow in humble adoration.